What's up? Welcome back to the channel. Today on one side, I have the iPad Air Generation 4 from 2020. And on the other side, I have the iPad Pro Generation 2 from 2020. This is the 11-inch. I've been using the Pro for the last few months and I'm a big fan. And I just got this for my mom. It's new to my overall arsenal over here. And today what we're gonna do is we're gonna run down the differences between these iPads. We're gonna look at the pros and the cons. And I'm gonna help you guys make a decision on which iPad you should buy right now in 2021 and which iPad is actually worth your money. Let's get into it. As you can see, the design on both these iPads is extremely identical. We have the new squared off design that Apple is trying to trickle down throughout their lineup. We first saw this design in 2018 when Apple redesigned the iPad Pro. That was the first iPad that was actually worthy of the name Pro. Now from 2018, we've seen this design philosophy, the minimal squared off flat edge design, get transferred and trickle down across their lineup amongst all their products, and it's finally come to the iPad Air. Both the iPad Air and the iPad Pro have LCD screens. They're extremely bright and extremely useful when you're outside.
The screens are extremely sharp and very color accurate. Even if you have to do any professional work on them, they both will serve you well. The only difference that I can actually talk about is the fact that the iPad Pro has Pro Motion, which basically means it dynamically adjusts the refresh rate of your screen to go from 120 right down to 24Hz, and that's something that the iPad Air lacks. Once you use it, you'll actually get really used to it. But if you have somebody who's never used a high refresh rate screen, you probably won't even notice.
Other than that, the iPad Air does seem to have a slightly thicker bezel around its edges as compared to the iPad Pros. So the bezel around the screen is a little bit thicker, which basically means even though both these devices have the exact same footprint, the iPad Air has a 10.9-inch screen, whereas the iPad Pro has 11-inch screen. The build quality on both of these iPads is fantastic. You're not going to be disappointed. The iPad Air does have one single camera at the back of it, which is a standard 12-megapixel wide camera. And the iPad Pro, on the other hand, has a 12-megapixel wide camera as well as a 10-megapixel ultra-wide camera. And to add to that, they also have the LiDAR scanner, which is something that they added into the iPhones this year as well. The front-facing cameras, on the other hand, are identical. They have 7-megapixel front-facing selfie camera, which is not that great, to be completely honest, but because of the image processor within the iPads, it's a lot better than what you get on any MacBook in the market. Furthermore, the iPad Pro's front-facing camera is such that it also has depth sensor so that you can use Face ID, which is something that the iPad Air lacks. The iPad Air, on the other hand, has Touch ID, which is an older biometric security system, but it's really, really useful in 2020 and 2021 as well. Me personally, I would have loved if the iPad Air had both Face ID as well as biometric Touch ID, but it does not. I'm hoping that does come down to the iPad Pro, the newer version that we're expecting this year. Now, amongst physical similarities and differences, you're basically going to see that you have 4 speaker grills on both of these iPads. But what you need to know is that the iPad Air actually has only 2 speakers, and they've just chosen to put the grills out there, but there's actually no speaker system and there's no audio interface under that. Whereas the iPad Pro actually has 4 full speakers, so the sound is definitely a lot better. That being said, the iPad Air does have fantastic sound, and for the price I wouldn't expect much more from Apple, but the iPad Pro is still better as it has full-fledged quad speaker system that's a lot stronger, the bass is a lot richer, and it's a lot more defined. Last year when the iPad Pros came out, Apple made a big deal about the amount of microphones that they've included inside this device. So the iPad Pro has 5 studio quality microphones. If you're creative and you do a lot of audio recording by any chance, you're definitely going to want to prefer the Pro over the Air. The Air has only 2 microphones and they're not rated as studio quality mics from Apple, which means they're not the best of the best. Now with respect to price, when you compare the base models of the iPad Air and the iPad Pro, you're definitely going to notice that the iPad Air, while it looks similar and it sounds a lot similar to the iPad Pro, it is a lot cheaper. The price varies quite a bit, but there is one drawback when it comes to the price. While it's a lot cheaper, something that you have to factor in is that when you buy an iPad Air, you're going to get 64GB as your base storage, but when you buy an iPad Pro, you're going to get double of that, which is 128GB for your base storage. Another thing that I absolutely love about the physical design of the iPad Air and the iPad Pro is that now both of them have USB-C ports, both of them have a smart connector, so they both are compatible with the brand new Magic Keyboard that came out last year. They also have compatibility for the Apple Pencil Generation 2, which according to me is mind-blowing. To be able to get these accessories with a cheaper iPad Air is phenomenal. And for anyone who wants to shift their creative work from their laptop to an iPad, the fact that you can actually use these accessories is really, really great. And the fact that you have choices between the Pro and the Air now is even better. And something else you want to keep in mind is that the iPad Pro is only available in space gray and silver if you actually go out to buy it, whereas the iPad Air is available in 5 different colors, and I love every color variant that they've actually come out with. Especially the sky blue color variant for the iPad Air is fantastic. Now I have both my devices in space gray because that's basically really what I love, but the fact that you actually have color choices is pretty great. While I'm a big fan of space gray myself, just having that choice is amazing. Now that we've already run down all the external differences between these iPads, it's the internals that make a bigger difference. It's the processors inside these iPads that make them so game-changing. Now, the iPad Air has the A14 processor, which is the same processor that's found in your iPhones, whereas the iPad Pro has the A12Z, which is a slightly more beefed up version of the A12X, which is the beefier version of the A12 processor from 2018. So in order to compare these two processors, we're going to run a Geekbench test right now. Keep in mind, I have used the A12Z processor extensively because I've been using my iPad for the last 3 or 4 months now, and the A12Z is a complete beast. But what we're going to do with this Geekbench test is we're going to figure out whether the A14 chip is a lot more powerful or weaker than the A12Z. Although before we get into the synthetic tests and benchmarks, I can definitely tell you that the A12Z and the A14 chip are still extremely powerful, irrespective of what results we actually see in the test that I'm going to run right now. A12Z and the A14 chip are so powerful that they can actually outmatch tons of laptops in the market, so it doesn't matter which way you actually go.
The first test that we're going to run in Geekbench 5 is a CPU test comparison for both the iPads.
Okay, so the results are in, and this is definitely not something that I was actually expecting, because when I bought the iPad Pro, I bought the iPad Pro mainly for its performance gains. I also bought it a couple of months ago to replace my Intel-based MacBook Pro for all my creative work because it was just faster and stronger and had a much better performance. But the results that I'm seeing right now with these Geekbench scores are actually surprising me to a whole different level. The iPad Air has a staggering 1579 for single-core processing, and the iPad Pro, on the other hand, has a 1121 score in their single core result. Basically means that the iPad Air has completely smashed out the iPad Pro with respect to single core. All your everyday tasks such as opening up apps, swiping between apps, opening up web pages, any of your everyday basic tasks are handled by your single core performance, and the iPad Air wins on single core. Multi-core, on the other hand, is a completely different beast. Multi-core on the iPad Pro is 4603 and the iPad Air is 4290, which means the iPad Pro still has much better multi-core performance, which in simple words means any task which puts a large amount of stress on your system, basically required for tasks such as video editing, photo editing, tasks that you would probably not use your iPad for on a day-to-day basis. Now remember, if you're going to be using your iPad Pro to edit video or for graphic designing, the multi-core performance is extremely important. And I'm assuming even though the A14 is a newer chip, the difference in the multi-core performance is basically due to the fact that the iPad Pro has more number of cores. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to run a metal graphic test on both the iPads and see how they've actually performed. This test surprised me a lot more than the standard CPU test, because in this test we were testing the graphics, and the iPad Pro actually has more graphic cores than the iPad Air does inside of it. And the iPad Pro scored 11,697 on the metal test, whereas the iPad Air scored 12,559 on their graphic test. Okay, what I'm trying to tell you is that the iPad Air has better graphical performance than the iPad Pro actually does, and that's probably because of the A14 chip. The A14 chip is a lot smaller, it's a 5 nanometer chip, it's a lot more efficient, it's a newer architecture on the overall, as the A12Z chip is honestly the exact same chip that Apple had put into the iPad Pros in 2018, but it just has one more graphical core enabled. But honestly, I'm extremely surprised, because I bought the iPad Pro thinking it's going to be the most powerful iPad in the market, but in this exact same year, only 2 months later, Apple releases the iPad Air, which is technically not supposed to be as powerful as the iPad Pro, but it has better single core and better graphical performance than my Pro does. After looking at all the results in the Geekbench test, what I'm going to say is that if you're somebody who's looking for an iPad for everyday use, you want to open web pages, you want to take notes, you want to perform tasks such as gaming because of the high graphical performance, the iPad Air is definitely the way to go. If you're somebody who does heavy workloads on their iPad, who wants to invest in an iPad and replace their laptop completely with an iPad, I would normally suggest the iPad Pro to you, because the iPad Pro has excellent multi-core performance. Looking at the graphical performance and the single-core performance of the iPad Air, and looking at how minute the difference in multi-core is between the Air and the Pro, I think my current recommendation to absolutely anybody out there would be to go for the iPad Air, because it's definitely more value for money when it comes down to performance. You have to keep in mind, you're not going to get a ProMotion display, you will not get 4 speakers, you won't get any of these additional features, but if you're looking at purely performance, the iPad Air is no slouch. Now, I know there's a whole bunch of people out there who may be confused between the iPad Air and the iPad Pro, and you probably want to go for the Pro because of the Pro name. I'm going to be completely honest with you, even if you buy the iPad Pro right now, you're not going to be disappointed at all, because the iPad Pro Pro and the A12Z has been tested by me, and I can assure you it's fantastic. When you do buy an iPad Pro, you have to keep in mind the fact that Apple is expected to release a brand new iPad Pro in March of 2021 with a brand new chip and a mini LED display, and that's probably going to be way faster than the current iPad Air which you're actually looking at. So I would definitely suggest, if you're in the market to buy a Pro and you want the ProMotion display, you want the additional microphones, you want the additional speakers, you want the higher storage variant, and you definitely want to go for an iPad Pro, I would tell you to hold off for a month, see what Apple actually releases, and then make your purchase. If you really want to go for it, go for the 12.9 inches or hold off and wait. So when you're making your purchase, it's going to come down to your personal preference and what you actually need. I hope you learned a little something today about both these devices, and I hope I've made your purchase decision a lot easier. In case you like this video, definitely hit that subscribe button, definitely hit that like button, and hit the bell notification. There are going to be a lot more tech-based and mobile photography and videography-based videos on this channel. Also going to be a lot more seafaring content once I get back on board. This is Nitin Chawla. Thanks for watching another episode of Essential Tech. I'm going to see you in the next time. Peace.